So the topic for the day is charts. Okay, so here I'll be teaching you how to create a static chart and a dynamic chart. First we'll understand what is this chart, how to create chart, and for what kind of data, what kind of charts we have to create. Let's open this basic charts. So why we actually have to create charts? The thing is, charts are nothing but a pictorial representation of your data. When you use these charts, it will be more, you know, easy for an analyst or anyone to explain about the data what we have. Otherwise, if you queue a data, the what will happen is it will be difficult for us to read. Let me show you the data. If you go here, see, this is actually a column chart. Column chart means we'll have vertical bars like this, and this will help me in comparing from each entities like this. Let me show you how to create this. Let's delete this. I have a column chart, bar chart, and pie chart. We'll do it in this sheet itself, and I'll tell you when you have to create these kind of charts here. Say, for example, I have a chart here. If I have a data like this, what kind of charts I have to create? Here, I have some companies and their sales values. If you want to compare between each company, then I can use a column chart, a bar chart, or a pie chart. If it is like this, just a simple data I have. So I have the company names and the sales values. So how to create? Just you'll have to select this. Go to insert. And then here I have a group called as charts. Let me select this. It's a column chart. Click here. See, I'll get the column chart like this. So this will be more easy for me to compare between each company. This is called as grid line. Here, this is Y axis. This is X axis. And if you want more information, you can still give the data labels here. If you want to remove this grid line, just select this. I'll just remove this. So here I have a plus mark here, which will help me in giving more information here. So to adopt more information, I can click on this plus mark. If you click here, see, it'll say axis titles. This axis title is nothing but the title for this. Now I don't know what is actually this axis is speaking about. If I say axis titles, see, I'll get this axis titles. Now let me click there. And I can type here company. Here I'll click and I'll say sales. Select this again. I'll click here. See, I want data labels here. If we move here, say I'll get a screen tip like this. But otherwise, still, if you need the data labels, I can just click here. Next, suppose if you want this data to be shown here as a data table, select here, click on this data table. I'll get the table here, bottom of this chart, so that it will be easy for me to read the table as well, along with that the data and the chart. Now when I say y-axis and x-axis, let me remove this data table here. These are called as intervals, means it will take the data and take the maximum value, and then it will fill in this y-axis. Now suppose if you want to edit any of this, say anything in this particular chart, select this control one. I told you, if you say control one, I'll get the formatting option for this object, or you can just say right click and say format. Now here I have so many options. Say first option here, this is for the fill colors. That is, if I go here and say fill, see, the chart will be filled here like this. Keep it always no fill, that looks good. The border, what you see, if you want to change, you can go here, you can change the border. Any color if you want, you can just go here, you can change it. Now if I select this, now the fill will change for this series what you have. click on this. See here, when I select this object, say the chart, then this is for the whole chart area. When I select the series, this will get changed. See, the formatting options will get changed. When I select this chart, this will get changed. If I select the series, the options will change. Let me go and say solid fill. Suppose if I go here and say I want to change the color, I can change the color like this. Let me go here. I have this border. If you want to give a border, you can still give the border here. Next, if you want to give some shadow and all these things, you can give. This is too fancy actually. Usually for corporate say charts and all, don't use all these. Though it looks very good, but it's not a professional way of showing, and it's left to you how you want to present the data. Suppose if you want to give some shadow here like this, see, you can actually give some formatting options here. Next, what we have here, see this option, this is for the series options. Now I have this series here. I want to make this little more bigger, so I can go here and I can, you know, give the gap like this. See, like this, you can increase or decrease the size of this series. Now let me select this, the y-axis. Now the option got changed. See, now if I click here, when I click on this series, see the options is totally different. But when I click on this, the format options for this axis will be available here. Now if I go here, I was talking about the interval. Now if you think that, see here, the maximum value is 19,000 and showing 25,000, that is by default. I want to reduce this. You can still reduce it. See, you can change this. This will go to 20,000. Now the interval got changed. It became 2,000 here. Previously it was 5,000. Now you can go and you can change that as well. Can I see this? It says units. It says 2,000. Now let me make it 5,000. Enter. See, this is customizing. But suppose if you want the default, let's say reset, it'll get reset. Scroll down, you have so many options here. You want the tick marks here. If you go and see, the tick marks will be this one. Let me select this, I'll show you. Select this, scroll down. These are all formatting options. You want, you can use, otherwise you can ignore it. See, I'll say outside. You can see that there is some line here. This is called as tick mark. If you don't want, you can just say none or say remove it. It will go inside, means it will go inside. See, like this. Cross means it will be like both the sides. The same thing I can do for this minor type. Minor type is nothing but the minute thing within this. Labels, say this is called as label, the x-axis label. So here we have, just say hi. See, this will go to the other section. This is the hi, means towards your right hand side. If I say low, it will again go back. None means you can still remove that. I don't want this, make this none. See, like this. So like this, you can do the formatting. So this is just for formatting. So it's your wish whether you want to keep it or not. There is no rule that you have to keep with the tick marks or without tick marks. It is left to you. There are some quick formats as well for this chart. Select this, go to format, and here I have few formatting things, and go to design. Here I have some templates here. Just click on this, automatically they'll get changed here like this. Why I'm telling this all this here is, so I'm not going to tell you for every chart about the formatting, because formatting of charts will be similar for all the other charts. So once I just do this, then you can follow this for other charts as well, because I want to concentrate more on the data, what kind of charts has to be created for this kind of data. Now when I have a data like this, wherein I'm comparing from one company to another company or one entity to another entity, then I can use this column chart, or I can use bar chart. Go here, and if I say bar chart, see, bar chart is nothing but it's a horizontal bars like this, which is similar to your column chart. The representation differs, that's all. If you see here, it is column and this is, say, bar chart like this. It is just how the data is represented. So you can take a call whether it should be a column chart or bar chart. Now let me select this. And if I say format, say control one, I'll have the same options here. See, gap width can increase or decrease like this. Another chart, what I can create is the pie chart. I'll say insert pie chart. So whenever I have this kind of data, I can either use a pie chart, a bar chart, or a column chart, because it is used for comparing the values. But what if I have the value, say here I have the sales, this is for only one series. What if I have more series? Let's go and check here. See, here I have three different year data. Let's assume that this data has been split now. Now I need to show 3 year data for the same companies. I'll go here, insert, and I can use this column chart. Fine. This is one way of representing. Whenever I have data like this, and if the heading is a number, there's one thing what you should actually take care is, see here, even this company is also getting plotted. Right click and say select data. Here, see, I'm not getting a proper name here. It's saying series 1, series 2, series 3. So what we'll do is, go here. Just you can delete this, or what you can do is, see, remove this part, that is this heading here. Just remove this label for time being. Now I'll select this, insert, and if I select the column chart, see here, now I'm getting this 2010, 2011 and 12. This is called as legend. The legend actually explains the color code for the series what we have plotted. Again, I have this x-axis, y-axis, and again you can go here and put the labels. So I'll not go again for that formatting part. That's why I just explained here, so that you can implement the same formatting techniques for all the other charts. Fine. So this is one way of showing. But what if I want to show such a way that, say, this company has got this total, the complete total, but still I want to see the breakup of this. So one is, I want to get the total like this, say equals I am taking this sum. I want to show the total here, say for this company. So this is the total, but in this total I want the breakup. So in that case, I'll be creating something called a stacked chart. What the stack will do is, so here it is like side by side. If you go and check this, it says how much? 19,713. Then again it is 5156. Then here it is 17,621. But if I do the total, I'll get this much. But after getting the chart, I want the split as well. So for that, what we'll do, select this. Don't select this. This I gave only for your reference. Insert, and we'll take this, this one. This is the stack chart. You see the difference between these two. Let me just keep it side by side. See, the data what you see here, these three bars, whatever is there, this is side by side, but this is one above the other. That's why it's called as stacked chart. Now let me move my cursor here. See, I'll have the same value here, but it is a complete total. You can see the axis values also here. See, it says 40,000 somewhere close. So what is that? 42,490. That means here somewhere it is close by. So 42,490. But here if you see, it says 20,000 because the maximum value what we have here is 19,000. So it is almost close to that 19,000. So you can plan accordingly. You can, you know, think what kind of chart I need to show. It is not compulsory that you have to show a column chart or bar chart. Again, I'm telling you, it's left to you and the client or your manager how you have to display it. As the reporting analyst or say reporting expert, you should know how I'll be showing the data. If you ask me, I'll go for this because here I have the total as well as I have the breakup. Similar kind of chart I can create for bar as well. Say bar chart. Go here, see, this is the bar chart. I can take and I can say insert bar stack. See, I'll get a bar stack like this. But I cannot create a pie chart for this. The reason is, for a pie chart, you can have only one series. Either I can create pie chart like this, or I can create a pie chart like this. I cannot create pie chart completely like this, because the pie chart here we created, right? See here, I can create only one series. And if you can observe, pie chart will be a circle where it will divide the values depending on the entities what we have, and there is no x-axis, y-axis for this. Right. Now let me come to this 100% stack chart. This 100% stack chart, what it will do is, it will give me the same kind of stacked chart what we have here, but this will give me the the percentage based on these values. That means the entity what we have, the series what we get, it will be 100% for all the values, and depending on the values what we have, it will stack. Say insert, and then if I say 100% stack chart, see, all the series will be 100%, but depending on this value here, the stack will get plotted. How is this actually divided? That is, it will take the total here, and this value is divided by this total, and this value is divided by this total, this value is divided by this total. So what will happen, adding all this percentage, it will be 100% like this. Let me show you that as well. Equals this divided by this, right? Now let me fix this, make it F4, and if I drag this, say percentage, if I add all this, it should be 100%. See, and if you take this bottom, see, every value if you add, this will be 100%. That's why it is called as 100% stacked chart. So it will be stacked such a way that all the values are 100%, but depending on this value, the breakup is stacked. Fine. So we saw this bar chart, bar stacked, same thing whatever you have here, that is 100% stacked bar chart. Select this, and here I'll say stacked like this. So again, this also will be 100%. See, bar stacked 100% chart. Then we saw this pie chart as well. Let me go to this line chart. Line chart means I'll have a line. Now let me select this. I'll create a line chart. I'll select this. Let me keep it like this. Whenever you feel that there is a trend which I'm showing, I'll go for line chart. The reason is, if I take a column chart for this, let me select this, and I'll say a column chart. See, it will be difficult for us to analyze the data. You can still do like this. There is nothing wrong. I'm not telling that you should not use this chart, but analyzing data, this will be more easier, because you can see the flow, how it goes. I know there are so many lines here, it will be difficult for us to understand. I'll tell you how we can actually rectify this, or say, create a chart which will be more readable in the line chart. If you see this chart, it's very congested. Now what we'll do is, for this, there is alternative, something called as spark lines. You see your same data. Spark lines are a kind of chart which is called as in-cell chart. In-cell means it will be inside the cell like this. Let me select this data. Now you should not select any heading, just only this data what we have. Say insert, and then you have this spark lines. Click on this either line or column. I'll say line chart. It lasts for the location. I will select this. Select the location and then say okay. See, the same line chart what you see here as an object here, it will be inside the cell. The same lines. But here the disadvantage is, I cannot have the axis labels, or say axis values here like this. It is just the flow what I can see like this. I can add few data points in this so that I can, analyze more easily. For that, I'll go to this design, and here I have this high point. See, high point in the sense, in this data, whichever is highest value, that will be pointed here. Next, suppose I want to know the lowest point. See, if I have any negative points, see, I'll click on this. Let me remove this. There is no negative point, right? Let me make one negative point here somewhere. Let's make this as negative. So minus, see, this is a negative point like this. This is called as spark lines. If you want, you can change this to column as well. Let me select this design. You can say column. See, you can change this to column chart as well, but you cannot give the labels inside this because the chart is actually just inside the cell, that is called as in cell, but these are actually the objects. Next, combination chart. I can combine two different charts, means two different chart types. When do we do this? I'll tell you. Let's read this data. I have a heading here, that is the data from 2003 till 2012. I have some sales value here and I have a growth percentage here. If you compare these two values, they are not same. Means this is coming in thousands and this is in percentage. When I plot a chart, any chart, select this, I'll say a column chart. See, I cannot read this data. Let me create a line chart. Select this, insert a line chart. See, one data is high because it's in thousands and this is in percentage. If you convert this into a value, say it will become 0.06, 0.03, which is almost like a zero. Instead, what I'll do is I'll try to create a dual axis chart. That means an axis for the sales and a separate axis for this growth. How to do that? Let me show you. Select this, insert, and create a line chart. See? Now what we'll do is select this percentage, that is increase or say growth, right click and say format data series. It lasts for primary axis or secondary axis. Just click on the secondary axis. There will be a separate axis for this series. Now both are line chart, which has got two different series, axis. Now suppose if you want to change the chart type, just go here, right click and say change series chart type. And if you go, see here, I'll get this line with markers, select here, I'll have a different option. Select this column chart, make it a clustered column and say, okay. You can also see here the secondary axis. See, if I remove again, it will go back to primary axis. You can change. See, I want this to be as a secondary axis. That also you can do. See, anything you can do like this. Say, okay. See, now this column chart, whatever is there, this is in the primary axis. And this line chart, what you see, that will be in secondary axis and we'll get the chart like this. This is called as combination. That is, I'm combining more than one kind of chart types. Guys, now we also have something called as recommended charts. What this recommended chart will do is any kind of data what you have, just go and click on this. It's like artificial intelligence. It'll just give me a different options for the data what I have here. Let me select this. And if I say okay, automatically the kind of chart what we created just now will be created here without going and changing all this series and all those. How it is coming? Because it is trying to understand what kind of chart we can create by this data. You go to any chart here. See, I'll go here. Let me select this. See, go to recommend chart. Automatically it will give me all the possible charts which you can create. Right. So you guys understood the basic chart. These are all the basic charts. And keep in mind, people, column chart, bar chart, line chart, and pie chart. Be thorough with this because rest all, whatever charts we get, it is completely derived from these charts. You go to a waterfall chart, you go to a Gantt chart. I'll show you all these things. They're all from these concepts only. Though this sounds very advanced, but I'll tell you they are very simple. I'll show you some of the advanced charts here, some dynamic charts, how we can create that. Okay, fine. The name sounds, you know, very much advanced or say different or so many things, but creating those things are very, very simple. Let's go here. It says butterfly chart. What is a butterfly chart? Let's open. Butterfly means it's not like it's very colorful. Butterfly means it has got wings. Now, how to create this data? Say, for example, let's go here. I have two data. One is yes and one is no. You could have seen these kind of things mostly in, say, election times. So mostly whether you like this party or that party, how many of you actually select this party, or you have some questions, how many are with this, how many are without this, yes or no. One way is I can select this, insert, and I can say a column chart over. This way also I can do. This is also one chart, say yes, no, yes, no, finish. But not always you have to do this column chart, bar chart, pie chart, something different we have to do. See, this looks something different. How to do this? So what we have done is, see, if you go here, there is one dummy series, what we call it as, which is actually created to bring or, you know, get this kind of chart. So how we have done, let me show you. Let me copy this and I'll paste it just below somewhere here. So what we have done is, in this here we need a blank space here and one blank space here and some blank space in the end. So we'll go here first, we'll say equals this. That means I'm just taking all the values of this one. Now I need a gap here. So for that, what I'll do, I'll take some value. Let's take 1000 minus this value. Okay, I'll say C plus whatever. I'll say 1000 minus this one. Take it as equals 1000 minus this one. It's not that compulsory, should take 1000 only. I just took 1000 so that it will be, cover this space. Next, this value, that is S value. So what we'll do, we'll go here, I'll mention it as S, so equals this one. Now, if you add all these values, it will be 1000 because I had subtracted the same value with 1000. Now, I need a gap here. This is a fixed gap. If you see here, I'll say some 300, 350, 400, whatever you want, you can do. I'll give 300. Say, track. The next, no. Here we'll give gap. Say, equals, select this. Done. The last space, you don't have to give anything because automatically there is a space there. Now let me select this, go to insert, and I'll take this bar stack. Done. Let me increase this. If you want, you can go here, select this, right click, format data series, and say fill, make it no fill. I'll do some formatting, just remove this, and here I'll take this gap and I'll say no fill. Done. Okay. See, and you can hide all these things, whatever is there, you can just hide these things, remove all this. See, fine. Next, one more chart, conditional formatting chart. Here I have a chart. What does it says? The chart says, if the value is less than or equal to 500, it should be blue. If it is from 500 to 1000, it should be this red color. Anything above 1000 should be 1000. The conditional formatting in chart we don't have in Excel, but conditional formatting for cells we have. But how to do these kind of things? One is, I can go, we saw that we can change the color here. So right click, say format data series. I can go and I can say fill color, whatever, I can do this. But the problem here is, for every time the value is getting changed, I have to go and change it manually. But how to do this dynamically, so that when I change the value here, say now this is falling under this 500 category, now I'll make it as 600. So automatically this has to change to red color. See, to do this, it's very simple again. So what we have done is, again, we have kept a dummy series here. What we'll do is, let me copy this. I'll show you how to do that. Scroll down. I'll just paste it here. Right. I'll write a formula here. What is that formula? I'll say equals this one. I'm just taking the labels. Next is, here I have the price and I need to categorize it with two different categories. That is less than 500, then 500 to 1000, and greater than 1000. So here we'll just put that, say less than or equal to 500. How to get that? Say equals if, just take it a little down here, equals if this value is less than or equal to 500, then I'll say take this value. That means if it is less than or equal to 500, let the value be this only. Otherwise, I'll say NA open bracket close bracket. So keep this in mind, this NA, what is there, not available. What it will do is, it will not plot the series. Enter. Now if this value is less than or equal to 500, then I'll get the value here. Otherwise it says NA. See, I'll make it 400 again. Now the condition is true, here I should get 400. See, if it is greater than 500, then it will become NA, because that is the condition what I've given. So C28 is less than or equal to 500. Now let me drag it down. Wherever the values are less than or equal to 500, that will come in this series. Let me go here. I'll take one more series now. That is 500 to 1000. I'll say greater than 500 and less than or equal to 1000. We'll come to this little later. First, we'll finish this greater than 1000. The simple formula, I'll just finish. Here, I'll say equals this value. Sorry. If this value is greater than 1000, then take this value. Else, say NA. Let me drag it down. See, any value which is above 1000 will come in this side. Let me make this as 1200. See, I'll get the value. Now coming to this, here I have two conditions to be checked. I'll say equals if and this value is greater than 500, comma, this value is less than or equal to 1000. Then take this value, else NA. So with these three condition, what will happen is, this value will either fall in this series, or in this series. It cannot fall in all the three series. Let me say Control D. See, you can see the value here. Here this is NA. Here I have this two value, then here NA. Then here I have this two value, here NA. So what will happen is, the value will fall under any of these three, three categories. Now just select this, insert, and then select this stack chart. Done. Okay. See. Now let me go and change this. I'll say 800. See. What is the logic behind this? I'll tell you. See, the value here, it is falling in one of the categories only. Here, one of the series. Now let me make it 200 here. Manually, 200 here, and say 200 here. If it was falling in all the three categories, then I'll get this three series here. But since here, I'm getting value for only one series. So what is happening is, see here. You have this less than 500. If it is NA, this will not come. If this is NA, this will also not come. Only this value will come. So what is happening here in this, any of the series, The other two is not displaying, only one is displaying. So whichever series are there here, the value that is getting displayed here. So that shows as if the chart is getting conditional formatted. See, getting formatted based on the condition what I have given. This is a small trick, that's all. Fine. Let's go to another example. Dynamic charts. Dynamic chart means, see, if you go here, let me select, see, I'll say all quarters. I'm getting all the records. Say first quarter, I'll get only these three. See, getting highlighted like this. How is this happen? See, I've taken only a normal column chart. I could have shown just like that, go here, select this and say insert and insert a column chart. Fine. This is also fine. My work is done. I'll say to my client, okay, done. But if you give something like this, some options where you can feel it nice. See, I want to know second quarter. Oh, it's getting highlighted here. See, just a visualization. That's all. So how to do this? Again, this is very simple. Let me take only this data and I'll go to a new sheet. I'll paste it here. Okay. Now what we'll do, we'll just hide this grid lines. Here, go to developer and say insert. I have something called as option button here. We'll create four buttons or say five buttons, whatever. We'll say all quarters. Let me select this and I'll say first quarter. Then second quarter, I'm just trying to create. Then third quarter, and this will be fourth quarter. Fine. I have four buttons here. If I click on this, see, depending on the selection, the chart should get updated. How will I know that which button has been clicked? For that, what you have to do is right click. Format control. Here I have this cell link. Select this and click anywhere. Say okay. Done. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. When I click on this, this says all. That means if it is one, that means I need to get all the values. If we say first, only the first quarter, whatever is there, that has to get highlighted. When I say second, then second quarter has to get highlighted. This is second quarter. Then third quarter and fourth quarter. Now I know the index of all the buttons. Say this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now what we'll do is we'll put the index number here. Say this is 2 and this is 3, this is 4 and this is 5. Why I given this is to match with this. See, if you can see this, say 2, that means first quarter. If I say second quarter, it is showing 3, that is this one. The third quarter, this one, which has got the 4 as the index number, just trying to match the index number. That's it. Now we'll go here. I'll say equals if this value, this is the value I'm comparing. Say F4 equals this. If these two values match, that means it is enabling that, say, what is this, the index or say that quarter. Then take this value. Else enable. See, it is 5. So only the values for these three values, that is this quarter, fourth quarter, what I've selected, should get the value. Let me drag it. See, now let me click on this first quarter. See, now it will go to this because I'm trying to match with this index with this value. When I say all, see, nothing. Now let me select this. Don't select this. This is for my reference. What I've given, select only these three and say insert. Now just create a column chart like this, right? A column chart has been created. Let me click on this first. Can you see this? Second, third, four. So I'm getting the value like this, but what I want is the highlight. Select one of the series, right click and say format, get a series. just try to give the gap width and this series overlap is the right, make it 100%. So what the series overlap will do is it will sit one above the other. See, let me increase this little bit. Okay, so what happened here is, since these two are of same values, when they're overlapping, it will sit one above here like this. Let me click on this all quarters. So what will happen? There is no value for this series. When I click on this first quarter, what will happen? This series will get the value. See, here it is actually not highlighting. It is just displaying the values for this series, and it shows as if it is getting highlighted like this. That's it. No programming, nothing. You can do this with a small program, say formula like this, just by using if condition. Next one, Gantt chart. Gantt chart means, I think most of you know, the people who are managers, they'll be knowing about this Gantt chart. Gantt chart is nothing but it's a process program chart, means the task management chart, the performance chart. Say we can also call it as a planner chart. Suppose I have a date here, I want to plan my task. So what will happen is, when I'm working on a project, I want to know, I have to divide the task. So for example, I have some say tasks here, and the task is starting on this date and it'll take 2 days. So I have to plan. So the project plan, what I'm doing, I have to plot it somewhere. So this chart, which is also called as project planner chart. So this one, what I'll do is I'll try to plot this such a way that, see, from this date, 2 days, see, it'll show me 2 days here. After 2 days, then again, one more task will start. So that will go up to 15 days. Suppose if I go here, I'll change this to 12 days. See, automatically this has to change. So this is called as Gantt chart. So how to create this? Again, this is very simple. Let me take this data. So here, let me select this. Just select this and say insert. Insert a bar stacked chart like this. Just create one bar stacked chart. When I create a chart, what will happen is the axis will be like reverse. First thing what you do is just make it all right. Say format axis here. It says categories in reverse order. Click on this. See, now I have this exactly like what I have here. Now this value, whatever you see here, that is for the date. I don't want to show this. So what I'll do, right click and say format data series, go to fill and say no fill. So I got the chart now. But here what's happening is, it is taking the default value, like what we saw, that axis values. It is starting somewhere from here. We'll try to adjust this. Click on this value, that is the axis values, right click and say format axis. Here it says 42400, that is nothing but the date here. The date value, it has got changed. Now what we'll do, I want to start this from this date itself, that is 3/1/2016. How to get the number? Let me copy this and paste it somewhere here. Okay, and then say control 1, change this to number. It says 42430. Select here, right click, say format axis here, change this to 42430 and say enter. See what happened here? I'll tell you the date what you have here, that is got plotted here, and it's taking some default value, so that this one is starting from somewhere here. So I want to start this from 3/1/2016. So for that, what is the value I'm just taking here, and then I change that in this minimum value, so that the value, whatever is there, the series should start from this date. The 42430 is nothing but this date value, and then I'll get this chart length. That's it. But here the thing is, you should arrange this data properly. If you're not arranging the data, then you'll not get the right chart. See, again, here also I'm using this bar chart. I told you, let it be any advanced charts, you'll be mostly using this column chart, bar chart, line chart, or pie chart. Fine. Next, interactive chart. Let me open this. See here, I have a value here and I've plotted one chart here. If you remember, a few minutes back, we discussed about this stack chart and also about the line above this, if it is a percentage. To create this kind of chart, see, I don't want the sales to be seen. Just click on the see, only profit and profit percentage is shown. I want to see only profit, see. I want to see sales and profit percentage, see. So anything I can do like this. So how to do this? Again, this is very simple. To look, it looks, you know, very complex or say too very advanced, nothing like that. How to do that? Let me copy this and I'll paste it. Fine. Just copy this and paste it here. Just one more dummy series what I'm actually creating. And then let me delete these values. Since I have a checkbox here, let's take a checkbox, developer, insert, and here I have this checkbox. Like what we did our one more chart, that is option button. Likewise, I'm just taking this checkbox. Let me name this as sales. And then as profit, I'll take three checkboxes, and then we'll rename this profit and percentage profit. Fine. So I have these three buttons. Let me keep it here like this. Right click and say format control. We'll have this cell link. Just keep it above this so that if I click on this thing, it will show me whether it is selected or not. Same thing let's do for profit as well. I'll keep it here. Save. See? Right click, format control, and I'll put it here. Save. See? If I select the sales, it will be true. If this checkbox are enabled, it will say true. Now what we'll do is, keeping this in mind, I'll say equals if equals, let's zoom this little, equals if this value, that means if this is true, I'll fix the row number, equals true. If this cell is true, then take this value, else any, same concept. So what will happen? If this is true, I'll get this value. Otherwise, it'll say NA. See, let me go and click on this. This becomes NA. Click on this. Now select all this by cell and say Control D, Control R. That is, I've just copied. Let me go here. See, NA. See, NA. Now this is a percentage. I'll just convert this into percentage. And then just create a chart. Insert. Say, create this stacked chart like this and keep it here. I need a line chart here. Say profit percentage is in percentage. It is not getting shown here. That is because it is a small value. So how to do that? Right click. Either I can go here. Say change chart type. Sorry. Select this. Say change series chart type. And here just click on this to secondary access. And make this as a line chart. See, that's it. Now if you go here and here I have this checkbox, see, select this, see, like this. So like this I can create a dynamic chart. Again, here also I've used what, only the stack chart and the line chart. Next one, positive negative chart. This is again a very simple chart. So I have a value here, say this difference. So wherever I have this negative, that should come in the other side. Otherwise, it should come in the right side or left side like this. Now, what I'll do is, let me copy this and I'll paste it here. And I'll take this difference value and I'll paste it as value here. I'm just taking it here so that it will be easy for me to explain. See, if I select this, say insert, and if I create a chat, see, like this, I'll get the chat like this. Let me delete this. See, but here what I want is this should have a different color. That means this value, and this should have a different color. Here it has taken it as a same series. So what's happening? It is giving me same color. One way is I can go here, select this individually, and then say format. You have to go and change the color one by one. But if you want to do like this, so what I'll do is I have to have one more dummy series here like this, and here I'll say equals if this value is greater than zero, okay, then take this value, otherwise in. Just select this. See, these three are negative values, so it is saying any. Same thing, I'll go here, I'll say equals if this value is less than or equal to zero, then take this value, else any. Select this. Now what happened here? So wherever the value is positive, that will come to this series, otherwise it will go to this series. Let's take it as positive, say negative. Convert this into percentage. Now let me select this, insert, and I'll create the same chart here. See, now I'll get a different color. If I would have taken this chart and this value, insert, and then bar stat, say I'll get like this. See, now what happened here? I given this in a different series, so I'm getting this different colors. Otherwise, it will be in the same value like this. Okay, so likewise, you can have, you know, there are hundreds of charts what you can create like this by your own ideas or creativity. Okay, so it's all about how you actually think, how you arrange the data, and then plot it. But make sure that you'll practice few of them so that, you know, that will become more easy for you. Okay, so this is all what we have for today's session.